Okay. So therefore I can write f of xk minus f of x naught is equal to xk minus x naught into g of xk. Okay. Where g of xk is a polynomial of degree n minus 1 with integer coefficients and with leading coefficient is Cn. Okay. Apo, this polynomial has at most how many solutions? Definitely n minus 1 solutions we should have, no? Because we assume that any polynomial congruence has at most n minus 1 solutions. Okay. Now, f of xk is congruent to 0 mod p. Because x0, x1, x3, if k is equal to 0, 1, 2, etc. up to n. You know, because x1, x0, x1, x2, xn are all solutions of this. Okay. So, similarly, f of x0 is also congruent to 0 mod p. So, this implies f of xk minus f of x0 is also congruent to 0 mod p. Okay. Now, what is f of x0? F of xk minus f of x0. So, already we have this relation. So, therefore, f of xk minus f of x0, again, which is equal to xk minus x0 into g of xk, okay, is again congruent to 0 mod p. Okay. So, therefore, this means what? This means anything is congruent to 0 mod p. This means p divides xk minus x0 into g of xk. But already I said x0, x1, x2, xn are incongruent solutions. So therefore xk is not equal to x0 mod p if k is not equal to 0. So k is equal to 1, incongruent. K is equal to 2, incongruent. So this implies p does not divide xk minus x0. So here p divides xk minus x0 into g of xk, but p does not divide this, therefore already we know that. So this implies p divides g of xk if k is not equal to 0. K is not equal to 0. This means that g of xk is congruent to 0 mod p for each k is not equal to 0. So everything is true for k is not equal to 0. Okay, valid for not equal to k not equal to 0. That means what? For each k is not equal to 0 means k is equal to 1. Apa x1 is solution for g of x. x2 is a solution for this polynomial congruence. x3 is a solution for this polynomial congruence. Therefore, x1, x2, xn are the solutions of the polynomial congruence, the polynomial g of x. The polynomial congruence g of x is equal to 0 mod p. Okay, but so this polynomial congruence with the degree of the polynomial is equal to n minus 1 has how many solutions? N solutions. Has how many solutions? N solutions. But which is contradiction? Why it is contradiction? But any polynomial of degree n minus 1 has at most n minus 1 solution, which is our hypothesis. What we have assumed here. Okay, so which is contradiction. So therefore, what we have assumed, f of x, the polynomial congruence, f of x is congruence to 0 mod p has at most n solutions. Okay. So against the proof. So whatever the polynomial we have of degree n and that Cn is not congruent to 0 mod p, then that polynomial congruence has at most n solutions. Hence the proof. Thank you.